Welcome to another episode of On the Couch, where we talk about relationship matters, love, sex, friendship, and social issues. I'm your host, Ariyike Akinbobola. Tonight, we are talking about a topic that I, as a mother, can actually relate with. We're talking about child bullying and the rampant increase at schools and in our society. Joining me on the couch, I've got three interesting ladies. I'm going to start my introductions from my right. Over here, we have Tewa Onasanya, Editor-in-Chief, Exquisite Magazine. Hi, Tewa. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Thanks for inviting me.
You're welcome. Okay, so let's move on to you. Thelma.
Hello, Ariyike. Thelma Nwogbo here. A lawyer, blogger, writer, as well, relationship enthusiast, I like to say.
So, over here, we have Thuke, Ojebobola, psychologist. And you have been here before.
Yes, so. I have. Hello.
So tonight we're talking about child bullying and the rampant increase in schools and in our society. So let's start off talking about it as mothers. I mean, three of us are mothers. Thelma has been a victim of child bullying before. And I'm sure, you know, most of us can actually relate with it. I've been a victim before. And yeah. So as mothers, has your child ever been bullied at school?
First of all, I've never been bullied. Thank God for that, because only God knows how I would have, you know, handled that. But I won't say one of my children has been bullied, but I did have a scenario where he wasn't happy with the way one of the children talked to him. And he was quite unhappy about it, to the point that he came home to talk about it. And then we had to find a way to sort it out and then, you know, kind of like tell him that, yes, it's not good for this boy to be saying this to you, but you have to be this, you have to be that. And then also speak to his teacher as well, just to, you know, show that we're, you know, we're aware that he's unhappy and we're trying to make steps for him to be happy.
What are the possible causes of child bullying? I mean, what are those causes?
Causes of bullying amongst school age children usually has to do with there's something we call the herd mentality. Like you're in a group, like five of you or six of you are in a group, and you see someone that is perceived as weak or quiet. Then all of you, like you said, you mentioned something. You said these girls were like the cool kids.
They eat
and
girls.
They felt they could come and just start making fun of you. And if you've noticed in social gatherings, if like you come somewhere and you see like a group of people, and you, there's no way you wouldn't feel intimidated. Even no matter how high your confidence, there's some form of everybody here seems to know themselves, and you come and you don't know what's going on. So there's that herd mentality, and maybe they just look at this person. This person looks like someone that we could just pick on. Maybe they perceive that person as weak.
Sometimes it could not be. It's not the parent's fault. It's just the child. Maybe just something wrong, and maybe you need to now explain to your child that no, that's wrong, don't do that.
What do you think can be done to stop child bullying in schools and in our society generally?
Okay, I agree completely with what you ladies have said. Another thing I need to bring up, I feel I should bring up, is we as parents, you know, raise our and we are so particular about their performances at school and everything. But one aspect that a lot of people don't pay a lot of attention to is emotional intelligence. I think when you raise children to know that this is also very important, emotional intelligence is very important, empathy is very important, compassion is very important, it will really curb to a large extent bullying. I think I'm directing a bit to cyberbullying or bullying in adults, because when I read some things online, I just feel like this person doesn't have a soul. This person doesn't have a soul or a heart.
Exactly.
And like, how did you get to this point where you could be so mean and unfeeling? I think these are things that should have been treated when they were younger. You know, and that's one thing I think a lot of parents and teachers should also do, teach them that they need to love.